That's no normal piece of paper.
What, that red thing?
Okay, you need to know what it is.
What the heck? Oh my gosh, that's so crazy fast. What? I thought I had it. Can I not get it? Oh, come on. God, I'm like choking on my own saliva over here. Can we shoot it? No! Noted though, we can shoot it. Oh god. We got it. No? Okay, we did. I was about to be upset.
We need to find other pages.
Wait, there's more pages? Okay, give me a second. Let me take a drink of my water. Oh, you're choking on my own spit. Okay. Of course. Oh my goodness. Oh, what just happened to me? Rip. I think there was an enemy right next to me. I didn't see that. All right, let's try that again. Wait, could I have gotten up there before?
That's no normal piece of paper. Okay, you need to know where it's going.
Easy. Well, demon letters.
One more page.
I don't think I came up here before. Smoking ban. Dear elected official, thanks to the recent smoking ban in my state, I am happy to inform you I will not be voting for you in the next election. What? As everyone knows, smoking is being banned because the smoke is toxic to the aliens that the government sold our planet to in a secret deal. Sir, what the heck are you smoking? Can we go back and ask that first? If humans keep smoking, the aliens won't be able to live on Earth. Our air would be poisoned to them. If you government traitors can't stop people from smoking, then you won't get your millions of dollars from the aliens. I have a website. People know what's going on. We're going to keep smoking no matter what. This is a national emergency. Politicians are handing the planet over to alien overlords. We won't let you. We won't resist. I will smoke forever. What? Hey, it's Ati's, Did I have a mission for him here? No? Wonder why his, thing's here. I don't think I've been up here before. I don't think I could have gotten up here. What the? Oh. Well, I can't go in there. I have to go up the stairs. White Kitchen. Dear gentlemen of the Society of Sciences, it has been some time since I sent my initial letter. I hope it is not the case that you have dismissed my claims outright. In that hope, I am writing to you once more to ask for your help in understanding the oddity that has befallen me in my home. I have recently begun renting a new apartment in the city. The space is nothing special, though for a time I found the isolation quite soothing. Recently, I have begun experiencing a strange occurrence. When I'm in my kitchen, a tiny little thing with not much but a sink, I sometimes lose myself. My surroundings change. I find myself standing on strange dark stone. I stare out at a colorless sky, as white as undisturbed snow, terrified of moving. Perhaps this is a brain issue? I think not, as it feels terribly real. This has been occurring for some months now, and I have become frightened of entering the kitchen. If it's not too much of an inconvenience, I would dearly appreciate a visit from one of your professionals to see what they make of it. I await your response with little expectation, but with great hope. Huh. Wonder if that was the dude we had to kill in the fridge entity. Okay, there's one more paper apparently somewhere. Pinstripe world. I'm a plaid suit in a pinstripe world. I'm a plaid suit. Is that just what it says over and over? Wait, why is that one redacted? What? Weird. We can hear freaking Auntie's music from below. My clock is shaped like a cat, and its eyes move, and I think it's angry, but I keep apologizing, and it won't stop, and I said I'm sorry, 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 so sorry, but it won't leave me alone, and I don't know what it wants. I can't keep apologizing for you. Do you see it now, too? It told me everyone is here. I need to be careful so they don't see me writing this letter. It wants me to stay with it, with my eyes on its eyes and moving very fast, but I can't keep going, and I'm worried they will forget about me, so I need to write you about this because I can't keep going, but the cat will because of its eyes, and then reacted. Jeez. What the heck? That person went crazy. Let's say, I think I hear it. Little paper dude, our whereabouts. Hey, you have questions and the prophets have your answer. If you are truly intrigued, watch the time. We lost about 45 days in the past 4 years. The shortening of the days, this is why the Vatican is a sundial, also simultaneously a keyhole. What? Another thing, while I'm here, if you want the secret to everything, compare plasma next to brain cells. The sun plus moon are composed of plasma, simply light, not planets. After this is cemented in your seek, ponder the current whereabouts of where you, I, and humanity reside. The heck?
Okay, you need to know where it's gonna end up.
Easy! Letters. A stack of four envelopes, each containing a single page of paper. All four letters are illegible due to extreme water damage. The envelopes curiously do not show any sign of such damage and are covered in messages of love. Huh. Vivid dreams. To the esteemed members of the American Psychiatric Council, I am writing you to inquire about the significance of dreams in relation to one's mental health. I am aware that there are many books purporting to contain the true meaning of dreams, but I have reservations about their legitimacy. I understand that this is not usually done, but if I would greatly appreciate your thoughts on my condition. Ever since I was young, I have had intensely vivid dreams. They only occur sporadically, but in them, I witness very strange events. I understand dreams can seem real at the time, but these feel markedly different. They do not occur often, perhaps only one or two a year. Last night, I had one. I saw a small, empty town. It was utterly dark. There was a lake at its center. Shadows of people moved around me, muttering odd things. A bright light woke me up. I was screaming in my sleep. My wife had been shaking me for minutes before I woke. Because of this recent incident, I have decided to seek help. The doctors say I'm physically fine, but I wanted to consult your expertise. Thank you for your valuable time. Huh. Wonder what that was about. Oh no. What happened back here? So many letters they get stuck in the frickin' elevators? Interesting. Guess we can't reach the higher levels. Okay. The other one's in containment, apparently. Oh, but we can't get to it yet. Can't do that yet. I guess we'll do the face of the enemy. Let's look at our items first. Oh yeah, the spin. We upgraded that. Forgot. Thank you. guess we're gonna go meet our brother, finally. I have nothing else to do. Time to go meet brother dearest. See how crazy he is, if he is at all. All right. Big moment. Where is he?
The resonance emitted from the X-rays is purely antithetical to every variant of the hiss signal I can arrange. But how did Darling create it?
Okay, timeline of events. To examine the invasion's timeline events for possible patterns in his behavior. Establishing a timeline is difficult at present because of lack of reliable communications between Bureau sectors and staff. Preliminary models indicate ground zero of the invasion is located within the executive sector. Once it becomes possible to interview surviving personnel, pinpointing the exact location should be feasible. Other outstanding questions that a timeline may help answer. How did the HISS get past the internal lockdown? How does HISS resonance advance through space? Deliberately or uniformly? What is their ultimate goal? The outside world or cross-dimensional destination? Those are good questions. I like how this room keeps filling up with stuff the longer we go on. Speech analysis. If we understand the hiss to be a force based on vibration and resonance, then perhaps their incantation, which is now the agreed upon term for their vocalization, is an effort to express that resonance using human vocal cords in speech. Would there be differences if the incantation were recited in a different language? The most common word used is want. Interestingly, every usage of the word is attributed to a you. You want to listen. You want this to be true. You must want these waves to drag you away. Are we the you in the hiss are referring to? Does the HISS believe humanity, possibly all non-HISS life, wants to join it? To be consumed by it? Is that its goal? The second most used words are through and time. Is this possibly the HISS stating how they arrived here, or an indication of its age? There is clear intention in the words. Dismissing the incantation as nonsense, as some of my colleagues recommend, is beyond idiotic. Dang. Hey, Emily. Where's my brother?
It's happening. After all these years, Dylan is here.
Keep it together.
But am I too late? How is he? I need to know.
He's clearly been affected by the hiss, but it's different than any other manifestation we've recorded. Maybe what makes you so special is genetic. He was a prime kid.
No.
Maybe it's Polaris protecting him, something else affecting the situation. I need to run tests. He seems more in control, more present.
Uh-oh. That doesn't sound good, though.
I want to see him. My brother. Or is he?
Of course. Now, Marshall set up an HRA-warded cage to contain him. It's on the upper floor, up the stairs.
Okay, I need to go.
Jesse, be careful.
Thanks, Emily. Talk to her again, though. See if she has anything new to ask about.
Hi, Jesse.
Black Rock.
I visited the quarry. What's the plan for all that Black Rock?
The Bureau has used Black Rock almost exclusively for containment purposes. See, I say, branch out. Instead of boxes, helmets. Instead of blast shields, knives.
Knives?
Yes, knives. So many combat applications. Slicing, stabbing, gouging. Sorry. I've been trying to get Darling to explore combat applications for years. I got a little excited.
Wow. I did not expect that from her.
Okay, Arish.
This place is looking good.
Whoa.
Arish is making real progress around here.
Right? This place is a fortress. With him taking care of operations here, I can spend more time analyzing the hiss. I've been attempting to isolate and neutralize the Hiss resonance in blood samples, but no luck so far.
So you can't reverse it?
Not yet, but perhaps reversing it is too simple. See, if Hiss resonance can rewrite human genetics, then perhaps it's a question of rewriting the Hiss resonance. In theory, that could pave the way for custom human genetic alteration.
Okay, don't get too excited.
I wonder how often the phrase mad scientist is used around
here. Right. It seems like they only hire mad scientists. Status of HRA production.
How is HRA production coming along?
Better than expected. We've already made enough to get people out of a couple safe rooms.
Yay!
And they're here, alive, thanks to you.
That's great!
We never would have lasted this long if you hadn't walked in those doors.
True.
You deserve thanks too, of course.
Polaris!
We got this place up and running together, Emily.
Alright, I guess we're gonna talk to her brother.
Enjoy your data.
Also, where did,
Oh, I will.
Oh god, what's her name? Marshall go. Where did Marshall go?
Welcome back.
I'm gonna talk to him real quick.
Hey, I put extra security on your brother. Oh. No offense, but that dude is the scariest motherfucker I have ever laid eyes on. Like I said, no offense.
It's okay. None taking, honestly.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
Okay, he's on the second
watch
floor.
Watch yourself out there.
We'll do Arish. Wait, I don't even know exactly where he is. They said upper floors contain an HRA, like, cage?
Stabilizing. Marshall abandons us. I'm sick of no one telling us what's going on.
Yeah, where did Marshall go?
Always been on a need-to-know basis.
Well, I need to fucking know. I'm an upper-level executive, dammit.
Listen, Agent, well, I'm with you. Like, I need to effing know, too. Like, hello? Pope's promotion. Dr. Yarley has personally recommended Miss Pope for a promotion based on her work ethic and assisted in advancing many ongoing research matters. For breakthroughs resulting from her work, huh? According to her colleagues, Pope has displayed a keen eye for detail and quick grasp for paranatural, or grasp of paranatural concepts. She is professionally and diligent. Professional and diligent. Jeez, I can't speak. Though some of her co-workers complain of social disinterest. The review committee approves this recommendation and promotes Ms. Pope to the position of research specialist. Ooh. Ooh, there's like notes now. Ah. Collective unconscious. Collective unconscious is defined as a form of the unconscious that is shared in all humans' minds. From this arises unconscious knowledge linking us through our ancestral heritage. Though this collective unconscious, we unknowingly attribute a series of images and archetypes to all elements of our lives. These archetypes were never fixed, but shift and change in tandem with our species and culture. This eternal belief in the power of image shared by a massive population is blank, in the creation of altar items and objects of power. The sheer amount of blank exuded is attracted to the best representation of that image, imbuing a single object with a massive amount of blank. Theoretically, places of power could likewise be formed by the simple power of sustained collective belief. Huh. That's interesting. Any more notes? Not in here, at least. Oh, I thought that was a door.
Apparently the director restored HRA production.
I
They're
did.
Already getting other survivors out of safe rooms.
Great. Maybe I can get back to my office soon. I miss having a door to close on people.
I think you're gonna have to endure the inconvenience a little longer.
Dang. Oh. Okay. Kinda wanna look around for more notes now. They just keep popping up like that. Hey, dude. Is this where he's at? It probably is. This is probably where he's at. Let's go. Oh.
Your
Wait, was his hand disappearing?
Through a mirror inverted his meteorite. They feared inside by the door, pushed the fingers through the surface into the web. You've always been in there. You want this to be true. We stand around you while you dream. You can almost hear our words, but you forget.
What? They like made a control point for him too. Okay, let's talk to him. Dylan?
Shit. That's Dylan. Can you hear me? Oh, come on, Dylan. I'm here. I found you. Do you know who I am? You know me. Say it.
You are Dylan Faden's sister.
What?
He's talking in the third person.
Oh, that's not good.
Always a good sign. Do you know who you are?
Not Dylan.
Who are you?
Trench and Darling made sure of that.
What?
I'm P6. P6. But I'm better now. The hiss made me better.
Push the fingers through the surface.
Oh my god.
You've always been the new you. You want this
Can you stop
to be true.
That? Please. Not exactly the reunion I'd hoped for.
It feels good to say those words. I want to say them.
Oh god, he's crazy.
They sound good. They make me feel good. Don't you want to say them too?
No. Fuck off, no. You need to help me get this thing out of his head.
You're gonna
if
tear him apart, though.
There, if there's anything left, you have to
you.
Help me.
You!
Ooh!
You came in through the hole in you! We let you in! You've always been here! The only truth! A copy of a copy of
what?
A copy of a copy!
Stop it!
Orange
what is happening?
Shit! He can see you. This is not safe.
We found Polaris together with my sister when we were very small.
Yeah?
In ordinary. In the desert, through the door opened up by the slide projector. But she didn't help when Trench took me away.
Polaris didn't?
She didn't give me any powers. All
what?
The powers are my own powers. She didn't help when they locked me up for years.
After the song time for applause, we build you till nothing remains. The air cracks and the truth will emerge out of you. You
Jeez.
Are home.
The Bureau brought the slide projector back here with
what?
Me. And the Bureau did what the Bureau does. They used it. And they found. They opened the door up to the hiss.
What?
That's the only thing I can thank them for.
There. There it is. We stopped the altered world event in ordinary when we shut down the slide projector. And now the projector's here.
And they opened the door to the hiss?
Your worm is a tune you can't stop humming in a dream. Baby, baby. Just plastic. So safe. Nothing to worry about. Funny.
God, he's so
I
creepy.
I welcomed the hiss. I let it in. To get rid of her. The hiss set me free.
To get rid of Polaris?
Polaris is using you. The Bureau is using you. You are a puppet.
You can almost hear our words, but you forget.
If we shut off the slide projector, maybe that will stop the hiss.
Your regulations.
Maybe it's not too late for my brother.
You must see the truth for yourself, Jesse. Sister. The horrible truth about the Bureau. The hiss is the better option. Go to the Prime Candidate Program in the Containment Sector. I have the keycard to get you there. Salvador wanted me to
have it.
Want
what?
It? Bullshit.
What?
I saw what the Hiss did to Salvador. What it turned him into.
Okay, Dylan. I'll go. I want to see the truth for myself.
I'll go. But only to look for this lie projector. You can help me. We can end this.
Oh, he gave us clearance level 6. We can talk to him still. Okay, let's do it.
I don't know what else I'm hoping to find here.
Dylan. Can we talk?
I'd like to tell you about a dream I had last night.
Off to a good start.
Okay. I'm listening.
I was back in Ordinary. Before all of this happened.
Okay.
But in the dream, I was alone. It was just me. I was the only child. A girl. My name was Jesse Dylan Faden.
What?
But then the Bureau came and caught me, brought me back here, locked me up. Have you ever noticed that our names, Jesse, Dylan, they could be girls' names, boys' names, could be anything. Don't you find that weird?
Sure.
I find that weird.
Sure.
The hell was that? Is he trying to mess with me?
Can we just still talk to him? What the heck?
Maybe Dylan's still in there. Maybe there's a way to reach him.
I'd like to talk to my brother, please. Dylan?
Dylan would like to tell you about a dream he
Another
had
dream?
Just now.
This again?
I was going to be the new director of this place.
Yeah?
I helped you get a job here so that we could be together. You were an office assistant. You'd make coffee and deliver the mail. And there was always plenty of work to do. And it stayed that way. Forever and ever.
Okay.
It was nice. Really nice.
That's debatable.
Is he like looking at
but
alternate dimensions?
The strange thing. The dream shifted. And none of it was real anymore. It was a game. We were in a game. And it was a fucking boring game. But you couldn't stop playing. And then it shifted again. Or maybe it was another dream already. Or maybe I'm just confusing them. But in this other dream, it was more like a musical. This is an ordinary song about an ordinary girl from an ordinary town.
What?
It's the ordinary story. She worked an ordinary job in an ordinary office. Something. And that's all I can remember of that dream.
Maybe that's for the best.
A freaking musical? Okay, I'm gonna still talk to him.
The Hiss from him.
Until they tell me I can't.
Can we talk?
I just had an interesting dream.
Of course you did.
Oh, shit.
That's fascinating, but let's talk about the Hiss for a change, yeah?
This dream was about the Hiss.
Uh-oh.
That's what I'm gonna get.
In my dream, the Hiss had broken free of this prison. This house, I'd set it free. And the president himself was there to welcome us. He was the first one to take the Hiss in, spread the word. At first, many people thought it was horrifying, that he was horrifying. But also, many people who heard his words wanted to welcome the hiss in. And slowly, more and more of them came around until the whole world was brought together by the hiss. It was wonderful.
Okay, thanks for sharing that.
For the record, that will never happen. Not as long as I'm alive.
What else you got, Dylan?
Maybe I'm just here to punish myself.
I think we are, yeah.
Any new dreams you'd like to share, Dylan?
I'm glad you asked, sister.
Uh-oh.
This dream, like all dreams now, felt very real. Like reality. And reality now feels like a dream. Maybe it's all a dream. Maybe it's all real.
Dream where my brother endlessly tells me about his dreams.
I was in a dark place. And there was a dark man there. His name was Mr. Door.
Mr. Door?
And he told me that there are many worlds, side by side, on top of each other, some inside of others. In one world, there was a writer who wrote a story about a cop. In another world, the cop was real. Dor said he himself was in all of them at the same time, endlessly shifting between them. I asked him how I could reach these worlds. I wanted to bring the hiss there. But he didn't want to help me. He didn't like the idea. What did he know?
I'm not
wild about the idea myself.
Let's go.
Here
more
we
talking.
Go again. Once more with feeling.
Let me guess. You want to tell me about your dream?
Yes. Yes. In fact, I'm having a dream right now.
Right now?
Oh.
Kurt?
That's new.
In this dream, I'm standing in the corner watching Jesse and Dylan talk.
Ooh, gosh.
This very dream. This very dream. He said just now. And repeated it again now. I'm standing there and watching, and that's all I can do. It's as if I'm trapped there. And that's all I have to say about that dream.
Okay, Dylan. That's good.
So creepy.
Is he still in there? Or is this the hiss playing mind games? I don't know.
Oh, we can't talk to him anymore? Okay. Okay, Dylan, we'll just leave you be. Oh boy. That was a lot. Don't be rude about Pope. She's doing the best she can. Okay. So we have level 6 clearance now. Which I am trying to think of where all the level 6 clearances were. I don't think there was any on executive floor.
Lots of errors on this floor.
Looking for notes. Alright. I think there was one in research? I I think. That was weird. I think it's over here. Yeah.
Why'd they keep an altered item here?
Who knows, but let's claim the control point. A recording, let's listen.
Debrief for Mirror Excursion 7C. Subject is Agent Hardy. Hardy spent approximately 3 hours in the mirror. The longest time on record.
The mirror?
Can you describe your experience inside, Agent Hardy?
What? Is he speaking backwards?
Agent Hardy is physically healthy. All tests have come back clean. Yet the speech issue has persisted for hours.
He's speaking backwards.
Calm down, Agent. It could be psychosomatic, but the fact that this only occurred after returning from the mirror makes a paranatural explanation more likely. I recommend a battery of tests and a class orange quarantine.
Frickin' just reverse his speech. You'll hear what he says. Mirror altered item. Okay, this proposal is to finally determine the precise nature of the reflected space within the altered item. Is it transplanar, psychologically generated, or rooted within our own dimension? How does the altered item know the space in its vicinity well enough to reflect it? Why does it reflect some materials but not others? Is the space a parallel reality? If so, then we need to consider that while we possess this physical end of the mirror, someone else owns the other. What purpose might they use it for? Can they walk through into our own world? What are their motives? Lastly, to what purpose does the altered item produce the reflections of individuals that enter it? Can these reflected entities leave the altered item? As with all altered items, we need to attempt to distinguish if this behavior is blank. It's totally reversing their speech. Why would we want to look at this? Huh. Okay. What's this do? Why would I want to do that? AI-6C, the mirror, does not reflect its surrounding with perfect accuracy. The environment seen as glass contains slight distinction. It is unknown why the mirror does this. If there is any blank, then it's something we can't perceive. The popular theory is that the mirror has a goal in mind, that it reflects the world it wishes were real, subtly replacing our reality with its own. While certainly far-fetched, the theory is worth noting here as a warning not to underestimate the mirror. The specifically designed black rock panels have been installed to prevent access from our side or the mirror's. For added security, a particular arrangement of the panels is required to open the door. Okay. We can figure that out. Let's look at this.
Looks like there's a mirror in there.
I don't think it reflects this one. Oh gosh, I didn't mean to click that button.
The shutters in the image look different.
They do. When I open this one,
what am I missing?
Like, will the door just open on itself?
What do these shutters do?
I don't know. Do I need, like, something else? I don't know. Maybe I need to come back. Okay, that's the mirror. I think it's showing this one open. Okay, those are closed. And then this one. What's that one? I think it's this one that's open? Because this side would be reflecting the right side of ours. Oh, is the second one open as well? Okay, what about this one? No? Didn't work? Or do I have it backwards? We'll come back. There was certainly level 6 somewhere. What was it? I think it was containment, yeah. The medical wing, right? There's a locked door there.